Let's start off together recognizing that this is all by His grace. And that in the finding of the lost, we see the story of salvation. And in the growing of the found, we see the plan of sanctification. This is Christianity. This is what it is to be a disciple who makes disciples who makes disciples. I tell you first, Christianity is a perpetual continuation of being in Christ and in koinonia, in supernatural unity. Listen to verse 35. Again. The next day. Here's the perpetual. Again. Next day. Perpetual ongoing. John was standing with two of his disciples. One disciple with two more disciples. Here's koinonia. Again. The next day. God's people together as God's people pressing in to know God and His truth. The second point. Reality of Jesus requires a response to Jesus. The reality of Jesus requires a response to Jesus. Listen to verse 36. And he looked at Jesus as he walked and said, "Behold, the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard him speak and they followed Jesus. There are basically two options. That's all it comes down to. Two options. You can dedicate and declare, "Behold, the Lamb of God." Or you can deny his deity and disobey. There are only two camps ultimately. Only two end results ultimately. Third point, most important, our Messiah measures what moves and motivates the heart. Jesus measures what moves and motivates the heart. Listen to verse 38. And Jesus turned and saw them following. Okay, so they're coming after. But Jesus turns and he said to them, "What do you want?" Okay, I see what you're doing, but what do you want? What is the motivation of your heart? What do you ultimately seek? Do you see this? He's pressing down into the depths of the heart. What are you really looking for? What do you really want? And any other answer but you, Jesus, is damnable. Damnable. Friends, don't miss the matter of the heart. Yours and my motive means more than you might ever realize. You see, to want what you get from Jesus instead of the opportunity to have Jesus turns him into something between a vending machine, Santa Claus, one who simply is going to fulfill the desires of the flesh. Let me tell you, that's more Satan than Savior. The Life Application Study Bible says, and I quote, "When the two disciples began to follow Jesus, he asked them, 'What do you want?' Following Christ is not enough. We must follow him for the right reasons. To follow Christ for our own purposes would be asking Christ to follow us, to align us to support and advance our cause, not his. We must examine our motives for following him. Are we seeking his glory or ours?" Friends, this is the point of that verse. Check your heart. I ask you, what do you want?